Hey guys, it's Raya once again, and no intro, and no, I'm not using power projector this time because I'm not in a mood to doing it, but I'm just doing it for now. So, anyway guys, today I'm reviewing Ryan Lost Dragon Kimberly of 2021. So, base the plot is, it's about Raya and Tuk-Tuk go and find the Lost Dragon, and that's base the plot is. Reason why I explain it, because I don't want to get into spoilers, just to let you know. So, Raya Lost Dragon, And so when it was announced, I wasn't too sure. I said I might just wait till the trailer comes out. And at the time, a great YouTube friend of mine, Evan Dizzy Reviewer, is really looking forward to this movie. And at the time, it is his most anticipated movie of all time. But now it's in Carto. I think that's the next Dizzy movie. So I saw the trailer for it. It looks really, really interesting. And the trailer really got my interest. Unfortunately, guys, sadly, I didn't get the chance to go see this movie in cinemas due to the lockdown and the lockdown bullshit. So yesterday I had to watch it online because I've done all Disney reviews leading up to Raya Lost Dragon, and all the build up to leading up to Raya Lost Dragon is now finally here. I review all Disney movies, so I watched yesterday. So what did I think of this movie? I gotta say, it is such a great film. It is such an amazing, brilliant masterpiece of a movie. The story is really good. I actually really enjoyed the story. And the animation is just amazing. This is probably the best looking animation I've seen for a Disney film since Frozen 2. So, as for the characters itself, Raya is a great character. Of course, she's voiced by the same actress who played Rose from Star Wars The Last Jedi and Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker. And she was also in Croods 2, which unfortunately, guys, my Croods 2 review is going to be another delay, because if you guys are only all Labrador, why not watch Croods 2 online? Honestly, I don't fancy watching Croods 2 online. I'm just going to wait till it's on July when it comes to cinema, so I can let you guys know. Anyway, Sishu the dragon is easily the best character of the whole movie, and I think the best character of the movie is definitely Sishu, and Tuk-Tuk is my favorite characters of the movie. And as for, sorry guys, check out something back I was saying. So, and also the next character is Boom, the kid. Great character. And the Corn Baby is awesome. She's cute. Way better than the Boss Baby. Yeah, she's way better than the Boss Baby. And, Tuk-Tuk is my second favorite character of the movie. He is just awesome, and Baby Tuk-Tuk is adorable. And as for the villain, Nanai, it's hard to pronounce her name. It's just Nanai, I think his name is. I gotta say, she's a pretty decent villain. I mean, she's a pretty good villain. And of course, she has a backstory of Raya, her and Raya as kids, which I won't get into major spoilers, because I know you guys gotta go watch it this week, unfortunately, in theaters or Disney Plus. But she's a decent villain. I would say she's way better than Hans from Frozen. As I said, she's way better than Hans from Frozen. And the story is... yeah, so those are the characters of the movie. And also, the voice acting in this movie is top-notch. It's just... the voice acting is just great. It has great voice acting. So, out of that, and also the soundtrack was great. And this is a very... and it's kind of cool that they're going back to original films instead of doing Disney musicals. So, because their last movie that they did was Frozen 2, which Frozen 2, in my opinion, is a fantastic sequel. It's an amazing, brilliant masterpiece, and I know Frozen fan 2004 will definitely agree with me that Frozen 2 is an outstanding masterpiece. But if you guys are wondering which one I like more, this or Frozen 2, honestly, it's hard to pick. Because I really like both movies. I have such a great time watching this movie, but it would have been amazing if I see it in cinemas. Unfortunately, cinemas closed in my area due to lockdown, and this is only available on Disney Plus access, so I really hope they do put it in cinemas in May, so we have to wait and see in my area. And I really hope they do that. I think that would be really good. And I gotta say, the climax of this movie is really good. And so, on of that, guys, I know negatives for the movie, but Raya the Lost Dragon is a fantastic masterpiece movie, and easily the best movie of 2021 so far. But it would have been awesome if I see it in cinemas. So, yeah, so It would have been awesome if I'd seen it in cinema, so fuck you, lockdown and COVID-19. Despite that nitpick, Raya Last Dragon is an outstanding masterpiece, and don't forget, a 10 out of 10. It's an amazing, brilliant masterpiece. I really like this movie. It would have been fantastic if I see it on the big screen, but nope, I can't because of lockdown and all that stuff. But yeah, so that's my review on Raya Last Dragon. I hope you guys enjoyed the review. And my next review is Powerpuff Girls 1998 and Foster Home for Magic Your Friends. So those are my next two reviews coming up. So yeah. So as for the new Disney film Encanto, well, I can't be excited for that film because there's no official teaser or official trailer. I know there's a first look, but I need to see the first trailer first before I can judge it if I'm excited. Of course I will go see it because it's Disney. So Encanto, I must just wait till the trailer comes out. I can't be excited over the film just because there's no trailer, so guys, let you know. Anyway, thank you guys for watching and hope you guys enjoyed the review. Like and share with your friends. And my next review is Powerpuff Girls 1998 and Foster Home for Magic Your Friends. Stay tuned for that, those two reviews. And what do you think of Raya Last Dragon? Do you think it's an amazing, brilliant masterpiece? And before I end this video, guys, sadly, guys, this movie made less money in the box office and recently. And apparently, Tom and Jerry beat this movie at the box office. Now, I haven't seen the new Tom and Jerry movie yet, but it's reason why, because the it won't be in my area until May. So I know you guys are wondering why not watch it online, but I will wait till it's May so I can get to go see it. So that's what's happening. So please go see it, support this movie, because I really hope this movie makes a lot of money. So anyway, thank you guys for watching and goodbye.